The new film Tiger tells the true story of a Canadian sick boxer who was banned from boxing by the association for practicing his religious beliefs. Here with more on the films are the actors and writers Prem Singh and Michael Pugliese. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
So this movie, it looks amazing, it sounds amazing, and it's more than just a fighting movie. There's so much more to it. Tell us more about the film.
It's based on a true story of Pradeep Nagra. He's a practicing Sikh who's banned from the sport due to his religious beliefs. So the boxing commission, like you said, banned him because of the way he looked. So he was going to go fight in the Olympics in Sydney back in, I think it was the year 2000. And the commission stopped him from where he was. So it's this battle between him standing up for his religious beliefs and his religious freedoms in the ring and also in the courtroom.
Yeah, well, let's start by taking a look at the trailer for the film, and then we'll come back and talk a lot more about it, all right?
Good.
Stay away from my girl.
Shit!
You don't come into my gym. My home, it slowly forced me out. Huh?
What are you talking about?
You love all this, don't you? Your face in the paper, your hashtags on Twitter, you're the big man now, huh?
You think I'm boxing for the fame?
Yeah.
I could care less about that shit,
yeah,
man.
Yeah. Find a new lawyer. Look at me. Find a new lawyer. Or you better pray to whoever you pray to that I'm at your first fight tomorrow.
Wow, like I said, it looks good. I'm excited to see it. And you were doing all those boxing moves, and you're getting your moves on right there, right?
Yeah, a lot of hours of training.
I bet. I want to talk more about that. But first, let's talk a little bit about the Sikh religion, because I don't even think people understand it totally. And some people mix it up with extreme Islamism and other things.
Yeah.
They see the turban and they just think sometimes the worst things, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Can you describe the difference between it and what Sikh actually is? And it's Sikh, not Sikh, right?
No, it's Sikh. I mean, there are people that pronounce it as Sikh, right? But it's Sikh.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, the whole thing is a misunderstood religion. I mean, there's, you know, Sikhs wear turbans, they have beards. Certain Muslims do as well, but I think it's just the portrayal through the media on what a Sikh is. I don't think there's enough knowledge about what the religion is all about, and then, which is why we kind of made a film like this, was to kind of shine light on the religion. But aside from the religion and from all aspects of that, this is an example, and the example of opening up your eyes, not just to the Sikh religion, but to any religion, to anything that we don't have knowledge about. And you can't blame people for not having that kind of knowledge because of what is being portrayed out there. And us creating something like this is not just focusing on the Sikh religion. I mean, it's telling a Sikh story,
right,
but at the same time, it's actually telling people who are indifferent and people who are facing these struggles, whether you're an immigrant, whatever your sexual orientation is, or your race, your color, your gender, doesn't matter what your beliefs are, but people are treated differently. It is what it is, but it's up to us to kind of shift that. And coming on shows like this to kind of spread the message is something that we're starting to do, and we are very proud of something like this. And we do encourage people, when it comes time, to go and watch the film to support it, because it's going to make a difference.
Yeah. Definitely will. And Michael, so what was it about this story when you first heard this story? Because it's a true story.
Yes, it is.
When you first heard it, what was it about it that attracted you and said, this could be a movie?
I think it's just, like Prem was saying, just the overall message that comes behind the film. You don't get a chance to really showcase something through the eyes of cinema in a positive light, and especially in this incredible true story. Like Prem said, we're trying to raise awareness to a misunderstood religion and educate the uneducated about the religion, but also at the same time inspire others to stand up for their beliefs, no matter what it is, you know? And as soon as he kind of brought this to me, anything he kind of brings to the table, it's like a creative process.
He's just being nice to me right now.
It was always like, no, maybe
Tiger?
But you got to see the bigger picture, I think.
I think
it's the movement and trying to get people to, you know, become inspired and to care.
Wow, okay. And did you think, I heard some people say before that Sikhs used to be, you know, really prominent in the fighting industry. Is that true, or?
Well,
the military especially.
Yeah, yeah. World War One. Yeah. Yeah, they had a huge. Not a lot of people know this, but they had a huge portion in the war, and they contributed a lot, and lost a lot of men, and fought battles side by side. You know, Americans and the British, and you know, they did a lot of great things. Yeah, definitely. Mm. Yeah.
But also, you can also just to add to that as well, but you can also see that the progression. Mm. New Jersey mayor is a sick man.
Exactly.
So, you know, I mean, in Canada, we have a representative of a party that's the first ever sick representative, and it's these are the progressions that we're talking about, right?
So do you hope your movie will continue to, you know, you mentioned educate people and tell people the stories, but do you think it will directly affect change?
We hope so. Mm-hmm. I mean, it starts with a few people, and you know, we have to look at the positive side of things. I mean, everybody is. It's nice to look at what's happening in the world, but it's also nice to look at what's positive about it.
Yeah,
you know, even creating this movie, sorry, buddy.
Yeah,
even to create this movie, it changed me.
Oh, really? How so?
Yeah, like I was naive. You know, I was uneducated about the faith, and I think as I continue to grow as a man, but also grow with the story, it really taught me a lot about Sikhism, but also not to just judge a book by its cover. Mm-hmm. Everyone has their own stories. Everyone has their own paths, and it's good to sit and communicate and talk and understand before, you know, we start pointing the fingers. So I think it's good. It opened my eyes, and we hope that it changes others as well.
And it seems like even people in professional industries like the media and the TSA and, you know, officials, you know, misunderstand or, you know, perpetuate some of the stereotypes that exist around the religion. So
it's changing, though. I think it is changing.
Definitely.
And I think it's moving in the right direction.
Yeah. Well, I think your movie's helping do that.
Yeah, as we said. Well, helping being on this show, too, helps as well. You know what I mean?
Happy you're here. And we have to talk about Mickey Rourke, too, because we saw him in there. And that's pretty amazing that he's signed on. But I hear there's a story behind how you actually got him involved in the film. You got to tell us that.
We basically stalked him.
He made me do it.
So we basically found out where Mickey he worked out. Where he would go to the gym. He goes to Wild Card Boxing Club in LA.
Freddie
Roach's gym. And we're like, you know what, let's just go out there and hope we, you know, run into him. So we went down there. And we went in there right in the morning. We were just, you know, like hitting the bag a little bit, like looking around.
Like, yeah, we're boxers. Yeah.
And then Mickey comes in, and Freddie Roach knew what we were doing, so he kind of made the introduction.
Oh, okay, nice.
And we kind of hit it off. We got a chance to speak to him.
But we knew, right? So it was, he comes up to us, and he's like, you know, Mickey's coming in. And we're like, oh. Mickey's coming.
Oh, what? Mickey comes here?
Really? I had no clue.
Yeah.
Well, so what did you think when you first said something about the movie? Like,
he was actually going to work out, so he's like, "Let me go work out. Stay here for another hour and a half." So we're like, "Okay, yeah, no problem. We just got
Why
here."
Not?
So,
right.
So he goes, and then we had a chance to talk to him outside, and we discussed about, you know, our plans moving forward, about the movement, about how we feel, you know, Sikhism is portrayed, and how we could try to change that motive. And it kind of sits in his kind of direction too. He's a boxer, you know. Mm-hmm. He knows this world, and he's a legend, right?
So. Yeah, that's the fear most people would have had, to say, oh, you know, we can't just approach him, this movie. I'm sure he gets it all the time. So it's like, you know, did you guys ever think this probably is not a good idea to just approach him?
Yeah, we did think that it wasn't a good idea.
But I think with anything, really, it's like there's always those, you always have those doubts, right? But I think if you have that burning desire and passion to really try to achieve something and I think nothing, you just put your blinders on and you say, you know, turn every stone, you know, over until you find a way, right?
It worked out in your favor this time.
Yeah,
and you guys also have some impressive artists that are lending their voices to the soundtrack as well, right?
That's right.
Yeah, we completed a